Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chanzo. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 7th of April. Indian PM Modi reaffirms gratitude towards healthcare staff on World Health Day. Taliban pulls out of prisoner swap talks with Afghan government. And PM Oli says next 2 weeks are critical for Nepal, urges all to stay home. And now for all the details. On the occasion of World Health Day, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Tuesday said, "We should show gratitude to healthcare staff who are braving all odds to fight the coronavirus crisis." India has reported 4,421 positive cases, including 354 cases in the last 24 hours. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Tuesday said the World Health Day is an opportunity to reaffirm our gratitude towards all doctors, nurses, medical staff and healthcare workers leading the battle against COVID-19. Throwing light on the importance of personal fitness to stay healthy, he urged citizens to follow practices such as social distancing, which will protect one's own life as well as the lives of others. This comes as India's tally of total positive coronavirus cases rose to 4,421 as on Tuesday, out of which 3,981 are active cases, while 325 cases have been cured or discharged and one migrated, and the total death toll stands at 114. Meanwhile, as authorities across the country are battling it out to contain the spread of the pandemic, Indian capital New Delhi's Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal announced a 5T plan to stop the spread of coronavirus. The 5T plan includes testing, tracing, treatment, teamwork and tracking.
हम सब लोगों ने मिलके, मैंने कई experts के साथ पिछले कुछ दिनों से मैं बात कर रहा हूँ, कई doctors के साथ मैं बात कर रहा हूँ, कई लोगों से बातचीत करने के बाद हमने 5-step, 5 बिंदुओं का हमने plan बनाया है. कि हम आने वाले दिनों में दिल्ली में कोरोना को कैसे नियंत्रित करेंगे. इसमें ये एक तरह से 5T है, 5T प्लान है.
Amid nationwide lockdown, security forces conducted checks on the movement of vehicles, while sanitization drive were also conducted outside Markaz building and surrounding areas in Nizamuddin area of New Delhi. The area had witnessed a meeting of the Tablighi Jamaat, a global evangelical Muslim organization that emerged as the hotspot for COVID-19. Moving on, a protest was held recently by journalists in Gilgit-Baltistan after a fellow journalist was allegedly tortured by the police while reporting amid the COVID-19 lockdown. The journalists blamed that they were victimized for mirroring the realities of the illegally occupied region.
Journalists and media persons in Gilgit-Baltistan recently held a protest against police forces after a fellow journalist was allegedly tortured by the police while reporting from the ground amid the COVID-19 lockdown. The protesters blamed media personnel are being harassed by police in illegally occupied territory despite having special passes to perform their duties amid the lockdown to contain the spread of the infection.
इस तरह सहाफ़ी को ज़दकोब करना, उसको तशद्दुद का निशाना बनाना, मेरे ख्याल में ये रियासती दहशतगर्दी है, इसको रोकना चाहिए. जब DC पासेस जारी करता है तो फिर कोई तुक नहीं बनता है कि DC AC को कि वो आके उसको तशद्दुद का निशाना बनाए और उसे काम से रोके.
The protesters demanded an apology from the Assistant Commissioner of Police over the incident of barbarity against the journalist.
जहाँ पर पुलिस का दिल जाता है वहाँ पर उनको रोका जाता है, जहाँ पर इंतजामिया का दिल करता है वो वहाँ पर रोक लेते हैं. ऐसी सूरत हमारे लिए काबिल कबूल नहीं है. जो वाकया हमारे साफी दोस्त इंडिया गुलाब बबूर के साथ पेश आया है, उस वाकये की हम भरपूर मुजम्मत करते हैं.
Journalists have long blamed that they are victimized for mirroring the realities of the illegally occupied region. They accuse authorities restrict reporting through intimidation and other means.
In news from Afghanistan, the Afghan government began disinfecting crowded areas in capital Kabul on Monday in a bid to contain the spread of coronavirus cases in the country that has jumped to over 360 cases with reports of 10 deaths. Afghanistan has recorded 367 confirmed cases of coronavirus with 10 deaths, the health ministry spokesperson has said. According to the ministry, about 2,737 suspicious cases have been sent to the laboratories, of which 367 are positive and the rest are negative. Amid rising numbers, Afghanistan's government began disinfecting crowded areas in the capital Kabul on Monday with the hope of stopping the spread of coronavirus.
که مختلف نوع است وسایت ما اونو ساحاتی که ازدحام است جاده ها هست گشت گذار مردم زیاد است حتی پلان گرفتیم که مکرویان ها بلاک ها بلان منزل ها را توسط پرسنل خود با همکاری برادرای وزارت صحت ما تمام بلان منزل ها را هم ما ضد عفونی بکنیم.
On March 28, the government ordered all shops, restaurants, mosques and public transport in capital Kabul to close for 3 weeks.
ما بسیار زیاد فعلا به تشویش هستیم برای اینکه سطح کسایی که مصاب به کرونا هستند روز به روز زیاد شده میره بالا میره شهروندای ما هم با تاسف با بی‌پروایی با این برخورد میکنن و ما کوشش میکنیم که با جدیت روی یک پلانی که وجود داره هم آگاهی رسانی کنیم هم توصیه کنیم هم از قوای قهریه استفاده کنیم جبرن کسایی که مراد نمیکنه به خانهشون میشه.
There are fears Afghanistan's vulnerable health system, devastated by years of war, would be overwhelmed by an outbreak. The Taliban has pulled out of talks on prisoner exchange with the Afghan government. The militant group said it will not participate in fruitless meetings as the release of their prisoners was being delayed under one pretext or another.
The Taliban on Monday broke off talks with the Afghan government on a prisoner exchange, a main step in peace talks being brokered by the United States after it agreed on a troop withdrawal pact with the militants. Spokesman for Taliban's political office in Qatar, Suhail Shaheen, said on Twitter that a technical team would not participate in fruitless meetings as the release of prisoners was being delayed under one pretext or another. This comes a day after the militant group accused Washington of failing to comply with the terms of the US-Taliban agreement signed in Doha in late February, which includes release of 5,000 Taliban prisoners and withdrawal of foreign forces. The delay in the release of Taliban prisoners by US-backed Afghan government is that the group is demanding release of its 15 senior commanders involved in violent attacks, reports suggest. Javed Faisal, a spokesman for the National Security Council in Kabul, said the Afghan government would maintain its work on the prisoner release plan and asked Taliban to not sabotage the process by making excuses now.
Nepal Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli, in a televised address on Tuesday, said that the coming 2 weeks will be more challenging for Nepal as it is starting the rapid detection test for the first time in order to prevent and control the COVID-19 spread. Only 9 cases have been detected in the Himalayan nation so far.
Nepali Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli on Tuesday addressed the nation to share the current updates on situation of COVID-19 and steps taken by his government to contain its spread. This is the first address of the Prime Minister since the nationwide lockdown that came into effect from March 24th, suspending businesses and all national and international flights. Oli urged citizens to stay home and safe as he warned that next 2 weeks are critical for the country in the fight against novel coronavirus that has so far infected 9 persons in the Himalayan nation.
समुदायमा फैलिने उच्च जोखिमको अवधि पनि हो त्यसैले महामारीको संक्रमण फैलिन नदिन हाम्रा सारा प्रयास केन्द्रित गरिनेछ.
Nationwide lockdown was extended for the second time on Monday and will last till April 15th. Authorities in Nepal said the extension was designed to control the flow of people across the open border with India and to stem the spread of the pandemic.
Bangladesh's longest bridge, Padma, will be open to traffic in June next year and will connect capital Dhaka with 21 southern districts, resulting in enhancing regional trade. Despite COVID-19 outbreak, several projects including Padma Bridge project are still underway.
Several projects in Bangladesh, many Chinese undertaken, including the country's largest bridge, Padma, are still underway despite the COVID-19 outbreak. All of the 40 underwater piers have been completed so far, which laid a solid foundation for the completion of the main bridge in 2021. The Padma Bridge's 27th span was installed on March 28. Now 4,050 meters of the bridge is visible. According to the revised deadline, the country's longest bridge will be open to traffic in June next year. It will connect capital Dhaka with 21 southern districts and is set to enhance regional trade. It is also expected to boost Bangladesh's gross domestic product by 1.2%.
Sri Lanka's armed forces band performed to a housing estate in Colombo on Monday night, with local residents enjoying the performances from their windows. Colombo has been under a 24-hour curfew since 3 weeks.
Sri Lanka's armed forces band performed to a housing estate in Colombo on Monday night, with local residents enjoying the performances from their windows as the city entered its fourth week of lockdown. In a largely empty courtyard surrounded by blocks of crowded flats, the band played and sang local favorites amid a backdrop of strobe lighting. Bands from the armed forces and police have been performing in dozens of low and middle-income estates scattered throughout the capital. Colombo is one of the 3 districts identified as hotspots for the coronavirus, where the government imposed a 24-hour curfew 3 weeks ago. Under the curfew, people are not allowed out even for exercise, while state agencies and private sector companies have been delivering essential food items and medicine to homes. Sri Lanka reported 180 cases of the virus and 6 deaths as of Tuesday morning.
Police across India have found new ways to generate awareness about the deadly coronavirus by wearing coronavirus-themed helmets and shields, as they appeal to people to stay indoors and maintain social distancing. Amid nationwide lockdown across India, police in Western Surat city are wearing coronavirus-themed helmets and using coronavirus-themed shields to create awareness against the pandemic, as they appeal to people to stay indoors and maintain social distancing. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi announced a 21-day nationwide lockdown on March 24 to stem the spread of the disease, and police across the country are using different ways to enforce the lockdown. A senior police official in Surat, Yuvraj Singh Gohil, also came up with the idea of using coronavirus-themed equipments to make people understand in an unusual way.
एक प्रतीकात्मक चित्र बनाया गया है कि लोगों को दिखाने के लिए कि अभी कोरोना रास्ते पे आ गया है. अगर हम घर में नहीं रहेंगे और रास्ते पे आएंगे तो लोगों को कोरोना हो जाएगा और ये धीरे-धीरे पूरे घर में फैलेगा.
गोहिल एंड हिज टीम हैव बीन गोइंग डोर टू डोर टॉकिंग टू लोकल्स, वेजिटेबल फ्रूट वेंडर्स एंड एजुकेटिंग पीपल अबाउट कोरोना वायरस, अपार्ट फ्रॉम आल्सो टेलिंग कम्यूटर्स टू नॉट स्टेप आउट ऑफ देयर होम्स टू प्रिवेंट द स्प्रेड ऑफ द डिजीज.
वो बहुत अच्छा लगा, इसका रिजल्ट अच्छा रहेगा. वो हमको अच्छा बताने के लिए आए थे, घर में ही रहने का है, वो उसका पालन हमें करना है.
According to India's Health Ministry, the tally of total positive coronavirus cases rose to 4,421 on Tuesday, and total death toll stands at 114. Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/AsAsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter at AsAsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.